FM News. On point. News on XFM. I'm Chris Otim. The Speaker of Parliament, Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga, has directed the Inspector General of Police to provide security guards to the Obongi County Member of Parliament, Hassan Kaps Fungaro. This follows his report to Parliament indicating that he lives in fear because of unidentified people who are trailing him. Fungaro last evening told Parliament that he was coming from West Nile to Kampala. Then he was intercepted by unknown people and has sought Parliament's protection. So this prompted the Speaker to ask the IGP to give security to the Member of Parliament.
Members, first I will direct the Inspector General to provide security for Honorable Fungaro, but also as the Inspector, the Minister of Internal Affairs, to examine the complaint made by Honorable Fungaro and ensure that both him and his family and the other people are secure, but also to investigate the conduct of the person he has named, the District Police Commander for Obongi.
The outgoing Nakawa Municipality Mayor, Engineer Ronald Balimwezo, has decried the scramble for positions which has erupted amongst the newly elected new party-sponsored leaders in local governments. Notable among the positions is the speakership and deputy speakership in municipal councils and districts where NUP triumphed. Now, Balimwezo noted that such fights affect the party's growth, warning the elected leaders against them.
That we are going to begin mentoring these people so that they can offer the best services without fighting. We want unity. And our president recently called us and informed us that the best way to handle this is through negotiations. One may want to be a speaker, but do you have the qualifications? Yes, you may have the qualification, but are you the best contender for that position?
Kampala City Traders Association have petitioned the Minister of Finance, the Minister of Trade, URA, and the President, seeking clarification on the $5 per kilogram tax on textile. Kasita says that the tax rates on textiles were increased in both rates by an increment of 35% as import duty from the original 25% to $5 per kilogram, meaning that a container which could be cleared at between 30 to 40 million shillings now goes to between 300 and 400 million shillings. Tadeusz Musoke, the Kasita Secretary General, says the tax is not brought in good spirits and that they are scared that if government does not come out immediately and intervene, traders are at a risk of losing their businesses.
We have discovered that this policy has negatively affected the targets of Uganda Revenue Authority. Because also us in the business community, we cannot pay these taxes. Yeah. At times we wonder, how did they endorse such a very unfair policy, which is killing the business community, given the fact that the condition economically, we are badly off, and then you increase taxes. Other governments are considering, how do we revamp the business community? And here in Uganda, they are killing the business community.
In World Health News, Greece and Austria are urging other European Union states to adopt coronavirus vaccination passports, which could help revive Europe's stricken tourist industry. The idea of such a document, likely to be a certificate, would be to permit those who have been vaccinated to travel freely within the EU. The proposal was put forward during a virtual discussion between EU leaders, but a vaccine passport faces opposition from some of the bloc's 27 member states. France and Germany says such documents could be premature because data on the efficacy of vaccines in preventing a person from carrying or passing on the virus is incomplete. There are also concerns that enabling a vaccinated minority to enjoy foreign travel, while others, such as young people who are not seen as priority for inculcation, continue to face restrictions, would be discriminatory. In sports, the Uganda Hippos last night qualified for the semi-finals of the Under-20 Africa Cup of Nations tournament after stunning Burkina Faso 5-3 in a penalty shootout in a game played last night. Now the game ended goalless after 120 minutes, but the Hippos managed to score all five of their penalties, while the West African side, the Burkinabe, scored three. Jack Komakech kept out Jacob Jiga's first penalty to set the tone before Kenneth Semakula scored the decisive penalty kick for the young Uganda soccer team. The head coach, Mole Biekwaso, attributed the victory to the boys' resilience and determination.
As Ugandans, we are very happy. We came as underdogs. No one expected us to perform like this, because this is our first tournament, and these have been our first games. But we dreamt a lot playing with superpower nations, Burkina Faso, Nigeria, Cameroon, Morocco, Tunisia. Those are all superpower. For us, we came as underdogs. We knew how we could play, because every tournament, they are surprise teams.
And that's the latest XFM News. XFM News on point.